Hey, what's going on, guys? Victor Chambers here, New Jersey real estate agent and entrepreneur, back with another video. If you're new here, welcome. If you've been here before, welcome back. On this channel, I provide you with tips, strategies, and advice to empower you on your real estate journey. So consider liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and hitting that notification bell so you'll be notified when I upload brand new content. So in this video, I want to talk about the four major mistakes made by buyers when it comes to purchasing and owning condominiums and co-ops. In full disclosure, what I'm going to cover in this video is based on a white paper written by my good friend Ron Laurent at Cross Country Mortgage, who runs the condo and co-op lending group. I'll link all his information down in the description below, but you can reach out to him if you're a buyer or seller and you're in the market to purchase or sell a condo or condominium. He has a wealth of knowledge in this space, and I just figured I'd share some of this information with my audience here on YouTube. So just by way of introduction, before we jump into the meat of this video, I actually purchased my first property in 2007, which was a condo that I ultimately sold in 2012. But also, when I first got licensed in 2011, I was based in Hudson County, here in New Jersey, specifically Jersey City, which is a very dense condo market. And so my early days as a real estate agent, I had the opportunity to cut my teeth on condos and co-ops, both as a consumer and as a professional helping people buy and sell condos. You know, condos represent a very large and diverse section of the real estate market. And I would actually argue that condos are probably one of the most complex real estate purchases and investments because there's more layers to them. And we'll talk a little bit about why, and you'll kind of see that when I talk about the four mistakes. But I would argue that condos are a bit more complex than single families and even multifamily properties to some degree. So like I said, condos and co-ops represent a very large portion of the real estate market across the country. They're very diverse. Every condo and co-op development is different, from the architecture, the location, the price points, and all the amenities and varying levels of amenities and features that condo and co-op complexes provide. Just provides a lot of variety in the condo and co-op space. So one of the contributing factors to the complexities of condos and co-ops are the fact that they're governed either by a homeowners association or a co-op board. The responsibility of those HOAs and co-op boards are to maintain the unit valuations, and they're responsible for the overall governing of the complex, of the people that live there, of all the things that happen with regard to the development, even the financial health of the development. And as I said, every condo or co-op complex is very different, and each condo or co-op complex can have many factors that impact the financial health of the development, but also the valuations of the development. And these factors are often not easily observable. So as a buyer, when purchasing a condo, it's important to do your due diligence and inspect the financial health and understand more about how exactly these developments are governed before moving forward in a purchase. So that brings us to the first mistake. The first mistake is actually not analyzing the financial status and the financial statements of the HOA. Every condo or co-op should have financial statements that are preferably audited by a certified public accountant that help both the owners and potential buyers understand the balance sheet, the in and out cash flows, the budget, and the overall financial health of the development. This is one of the major factors that actually impacts each unit's valuation. It's important to know that these condos and co-ops have what are called common areas or shared areas, which are the joint and shared responsibility of all of the owners. So for example, when there's issues that come up where certain common areas or common components have to be replaced, that ultimately impacts each of the owners in that development. And when we talk about unit valuations, we're also talking about the ability of the HOA to maintain the development in such a way that it's attractive to potential buyers. So one principle of real estate is that prices are driven by supply and demand. So if there's an oversupply of condos in a specific development because it's less desirable, that will ultimately drive unit valuations down. So it's important for the HOA to be able to maintain the desirability of the complex so that the valuations of the units can remain stable. Also including the fact that there's an HOA and there's a budget, that means each unit owner is responsible for paying their portion of HOA dues on a monthly basis. And like any bill that any of us have, payments can be missed or delinquency can happen. And when that compounds, that ultimately negatively impacts the financial health of the HOA, causing them to defer maintenance and repairs that would normally be covered through the budget that's paid through the HOA dues. One way that HOAs commonly combat budget shortfalls or the need to raise capital to make certain repairs are through what's called special assessments. These are additional charges to the unit owners that contribute to the budget to cover certain repairs that need to be made. So ideally, a strong condo or co-op development won't have special assessments because the unit owners are paying their HOA dues and the budget is being managed in a way that allows for the development to make repairs and have certain things done to maintain the condition of the overall development. Mistake number two is not reviewing governing documents. One of the important roles of governing documents in a condo or a co-op development is to allow them to maintain uniformity of appearance and use of the property. And obviously, because in these developments you're living in close proximity to other people and you're sharing common areas, there have to be governing policies and rules established that govern how these different areas are used and how each unit owner can enjoy their space without distraction and without annoyance. So the condo or co-op developer will create what's called the CC&R, which is covenants, conditions, and restrictions, the rules, and the bylaws that will govern the development. And just to break those three down, the CC&R provides a zoning guide for the development and addresses acceptable and unacceptable uses of units and common areas. The rules typically address lifestyle issues such as noise, pets, and parking. And the bylaws detail how the HOA is to operate from the election of officers, meetings, how the budget will be maintained, etc. The third mistake made by buyers when it comes to purchasing condos and co-ops is not reviewing unique factors. Now, in a condo or co-op, there are both observable factors and unobservable factors. So these factors include the investor ratio, which is the ratio of owner-occupied units to absentee owner units, the delinquency ratio, which captures the percentage of owners who are either behind on their mortgage or behind on their HOA dues. Other factors could be outstanding litigation or single entity ownership, which means that one specific entity owns a number or a share or a percentage of the condos or co-ops in the development. All of these factors can impact unit valuations. It's super important to understand all of these things because these are things that a lender is going to look at when they assess the condo association or the co-op association through various questionnaires, and it will help them and guide their lending guidelines for those condo and co-op associations. We'll talk about these factors in more detail in a separate video. And the fourth mistake, speaking of lenders, is actually working with the wrong lender. Now, believe it or not, all mortgage lenders are not created equal. While in many cases, many of them will need to follow very similar sets of guidelines, the level of expertise across various lenders for unique properties, such as condos and co-ops, could vary. It's common that buyers will make the first three mistakes that I discussed because they're either working with the wrong real estate agent who lacks the knowledge and expertise in condos and co-ops, and or they're working with the wrong lender who may also lack the knowledge and expertise when it comes to condos and co-ops. Working with an agent and a lender who can help guide you through the process of purchasing a condo is super important. And it can literally make or break your experience in buying and owning a condo or co-op. Agents such as myself and lenders such as Ron have a plethora of experience in helping buyers navigate some of the unique ownership issues and unique due diligence issues associated with purchasing condos and co-ops. Working with the right lender will help you fully evaluate the financial investment of purchasing a condo or co-op. It will help you understand how special assessments and unique ownership factors can impact appreciation or depreciation, and it can help you avoid higher costs and capital losses on your investment. So I hope you found this information useful. Again, thank you to my friend Ron Laurent at Cross Country Mortgage for providing me with this white paper. Again, I'll provide his information in the description below. And comment on this video and let me know if you're at a place where you're considering purchasing a condo or co-op, or just sending me any questions you might have relevant to this unique type of real estate. Until the next video, peace.